Sim.
Não.
Craving some Mexican food tonight, so I made white chicken enchiladas. I took two chicken breasts and pounded them out flat, seasoned them with salt, pepper, and some avocado oil. I threw them on the grill while I got started on my cheese sauce. I didn't measure the cheese sauce, but it's a whole block of cream cheese, a couple tablespoons of butter, about equal parts heavy whipping cream and chicken broth, a bunch of green chilies, and a couple handfuls of cheese. I took the chicken off the grill and started shredding it. Because I had tenderized it, it made it so much easier to shred. I added all the chicken to a large mixing bowl and let my dogs all try a piece. Then I added some green chilies, salsa, and some more cheese to the chicken mixture. To make the enchiladas, I dipped a tortilla into a green enchilada sauce and rolled it up with the chicken mixture. Then I just topped the white sauce all over it and threw it in the oven. I'm definitely making these again. They were so good. Alright guys, so today I'm going to show you how I make this chicken bruschetta. I made it up as I went along. It was the first time I made it, but it turned out really good. So I pounded out three chicken breasts and used an entire container of mascarpone and a couple spoonfuls of a store-bought pesto and mixed that together. Normally I would use cream cheese for something like this, but I had the mascarpone, so I just wanted to use it up. Then I'm going to put those three pounded chicken breasts in a casserole dish and season them with salt and pepper and Italian seasoning, but use whatever seasonings you have. Then go ahead and spread that pesto cheese mixture over the top and add some mozzarella. I would use the big slices of it, and then go ahead and add some more Italian seasoning. Then I'm going to go ahead and clean off my tomatoes, chop them up, and a little bit of garlic. I'm going to make a really quick bruschetta. If I had fresh basil, I would put that in there too. But I just did salt, pepper, olive oil, and some Italian seasoning. Then go ahead and reduce down some balsamic vinegar. And then when those are done, you're just going to top it with the tomatoes and balsamic, and that is dinner. If you like macaroni and cheese, keep watching this video. I'm going to show you how to make a healthier version of macaroni and cheese using cauliflower. Start by chopping a cauliflower head into really tiny florets. Rinse your cauliflower off and then throw it in the oven with absolutely nothing on it. Now in a large saucepan, heat up some butter and cream cheese. It's not going to completely come together, but once the cream cheese melts, add a good amount of heavy whipping cream and season it. Let it thicken up when it starts getting thick. Add whatever cheese you have, but I used white cheddar. I added a little bit of pesto, tasted it. It tasted great. The cauliflower is done, so I took out the cauliflower, added it into a large casserole dish. Then I covered the cauliflower with the cheese sauce. I made a little bit too much, but that's okay. And then you're going to throw it in the oven until it gets a little bit of color at the top. And then I actually topped mine with some grilled chicken and some bruschetta from last night. And oh my god, go make this now. First started learning how to cook, I would make all the time, especially I would bring these to parties. People always loved them. Start by cleaning off your mushroom with a damp paper towel, remove the stem and scoop out a little bit of the inside so that you can stuff them. My mixture is just going to be a bunch of chopped spinach, a block of cream cheese, minced garlic, garlic powder, salt, pepper, and a little hot sauce, and then I'm going to spoon those into the mushrooms. Dip the tops in mozzarella or parmesan, throw them in the air fryer for about 20 minutes. They are so good. If you try them, let me know what you think. Hey guys, I'm going to a barbecue today, so I want to show you how I make my elote dip. I start off with a giant can of corn and about a cup of mayonnaise, and then I'm going to go ahead and juice two limes in there completely. Then start chopping up some cilantro and add that in there. Then go ahead and add a little can of diced jalapenos and some cotija cheese. Taste it. If it tastes good, top it with more cotija and some tajin. And yeah, go ahead and eat this with chips, pork rinds, whatever you want. It is bomb and only 6 ingredients.